हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज़ मोशन इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिसप्लेसमेंट एंड द डिस्टेंस. सो लेट्स सी द व्हाट इज डिस्टेंस फर्स्ट. सो डिस्टेंस इज अ मेजर ऑफ एनी रैंडम पाथ दैट इज कवर्ड विद इन अ टाइम बाई अ बॉडी. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव दिस टू इनिशियल पॉइंट्स. That is the A is the initial condition when the body is at t equal to 0 time. Okay, that is the reference point we have taken. Okay, and we have this point that is B on the positive, because if it is 0, then this direction is representing positive x direction and this direction is representing the negative direction. So if a body wants to go from A to B, so it can take either a path 1, that is a straight line between them. It can either take the second route, that is going like this, a curve, or it can also go taking the path route number 3. So distance is therefore a free route that you can take. That means you are free to take any of one the route. So we can say the if it takes the second route, so the complete measure of this route is known as the distance covered by the body. Now we also see that there can be infinite number of routes that can lead us from A to B. So a distance is something that is a multiple valued quantity. Okay, multiple valued quantity. Now let's talk about the displacement. So displacement is basically the shortest distance between the two points or two locations. For example, if you take A and B, and among these given three routes, if I ask you that what is the shortest distance, then we are seeing clearly then there is the first route only, that is only the shortest between the A and B. Okay, so what we found that it is the shortest distance between the two points. Why? Now let's see the second point. So distance is our scalar quantity. Why? Because that is just a random path. If you can see here, it is not depending on the direction. It can have any value in any direction. So that's why it is scalar. But talking about the displacement, then it is a quantity that also depends on direction, because it is the shortest route, and shortest route means it is depending on a particular direction only. So it is a vector quantity. Now let's see what are the possible values of our distance and displacement. So we are taking this initial again, and this is a final. So if I ask you that if the body is initially at A and it do not moves with respect to changing time. So you can see A itself lying at the A. So that means it do not move, it do not covers any type of length. So we can say our distance is 0 in that case. But if I say let the body move from A to B covering distance L and then again return to A in the course of time, then what is the distance? Then in that case, you will take L length covered, okay, and then returning also taken as the plus L, because it do not consider, we will not consider a distance direction. Okay, so therefore it can become L plus L even if the body returns to its original position, and thus distance can have a positive value. And by this example, there can't be any condition that we can say our distance is negative. So there are only two these possible values for the distance. Now talking about the displacement, if we see, then if the body do not moves, then displacement is 0 again. Okay, now if I say if the body is moving from A to B, okay, that is on the positive direction, so we can say it is having a positive value of displacement. Now after A to B, if we take that B, from B it is again returning to A. So this time what we see, there is a displacement which depends on direction. So if it covers plus L in the positive direction, then from B to A it again covered minus L coming to the A. So L minus L will become 0. That means the shortest distance between the A itself is 0. So in that case also we have a 0 value. Now considering from that after coming to A, let's suppose the body covered in the negative direction up to C, and consider this length as minus L by 2 because it is on the negative side of the reference, or you can say origin. So that's why we can say if it moves from A to C, so it can also have a negative value. So these are the three possible values between the displacement and distance. Now let's talk about the fourth point. So what we see that in every case distance is the short, if the distance we take a shortest, then it is equal to displacement. Or there is always a case that distance is always appearing to be larger than or greater than the displacement. So what we see, distance can be equal to or greater than our displacement. Okay, so that is a very important case, and that we can write in here also, that our displacement is always less than or equal to the distance. So these are the basic differences between the displacement and the distance. We can also take one more example for that. Like we can take a circular route to go from one point to other. So let's suppose this is our origin at t equal to 0 and body moves in anti-clockwise. So if I ask you with a let's suppose the radius is r, so if the body is covering along this route and reaches again this point, okay, again reaches this point, then what is the distance? If we ask about distance, what is the covered? So you will say the total measured length along this circle circumference is known as the distance. So we can say 2 pi r is a distance that is covered by the body. But if it is asked about the displacement, then what you see that it is started from 0 and finally again reached to 0. So it is again a point that we are getting. So there is no distance between the, or shortest path between the points, and thus we can say our displacement is finally 0. So now we will talk about the other specific terms, that are speed and the velocity. So we will see first what is speed. So speed is defined as the distance covered by the body while motion in a given time. Okay, so it is the ratio of the distance that is covered by the body in a given interval of time. So that is known as the speed of the body, and it is a scalar quantity because it is depending on the distance. So that is the first point, that is, it is scalar. The second thing we have seen, that distance can only have either a zero value or a positive value. So we can also say speed can also only have a positive or zero value. Okay, and with the speed we can also write a dimension formula, that is distance upon time. So it will become Lt minus 1 as its dimensional formula. Now let's see that what are the different kinds of speed that we can see in our kinematics. So the first is known as the uniform speed. So uniform word is made from unit, that is the one, or you can say something that is of the one form only. Okay, that is the same form, or you can say constant. So when the body is moving with a constant speed, that is known as the uniform speed. So how, let's see how we can define it. So if a body covering equal distances in equal interval of time, then such a motion is known as the uniform speed. Okay, for example, if we take t equal to 0 and x equal to 0 for a body, and the body start moving at this t equal to 0, so what we will see that in every second, if it's covering same distance, for example if it's covering 5 meters, then in the second duration of 1 second it is covering again 5 meters, and in third also it's covering 5 meters. So in such a case the body is said to be in the uniform motion. We can also see a graph for it, that will be more specific to view. So if we take the two axis graph, let's take the x as a time and y as a distance, and let's plot the points. So take this here 0, this is 1 second, this is second, and this is third second. Okay, so in one it is covering 5, so let's make it 5. This is our 5. In the other second it is covering 10 meters, because from here if you see this is 5 and this is 5, that is 5 plus 5 10. So again let's plot here, that is our second point, and at the third duration it covers again, that is 15. 5 plus 5 plus 5, so what we will get? So let's connect all the points. So what we see that we are getting a straight line. So for the uniform speed, what we get? The straight line curve for the between the distance and the time. So that is about uniform. Now let's see about the variable speed. Variable speed, or you can also called it as a non-uniform speed. So there are two conditions when the your speed will become variable. So the first condition is when a body covers unequal distance, unequal distance in equal interval of time, in equal interval of time, then it is also known as variable speed. Or if body is covering equal interval of distance, sorry, equal distances but in unequal interval of time, then such a motion is called as the variable speed motion. Okay, and what is the basic thing in the graph? We will see that whenever between the distance and time you are not getting a straight line, then you directly think about that it is the variable speed. Okay, so we do not get a straight line. Okay, no straight line curve we get in case of variable speed. No straight line curve between the distance and time. Okay, one thing you have to remember, that it is between distance and the time. We are not talking about the distance between velocity and time, and we will see that in the upcoming topics. So that is only about the distance and time, we will not get the straight line. Now let's talk about the third one, that is our average speed. So what is our average speed? So while traveling a long distance, like if you are traveling from city, so that's, in that case your velocity is lower. Okay, that your speed is lower. Okay, and when you are going to the highway, then you increase your speed to cover a long distance. So let's suppose you are covering S1 distance, or let's take it D would be more appropriate. Let's you have covered D1 in T1 time duration and D2 in T2 time duration. So in such a case, if you want to say that what is your average speed, so it is the ratio of total distance, the total distance traveled upon total time taken. Total time taken. Okay. So what is your total distance? That is D1 plus D2 upon T1 plus T2 is your time. So that is your average speed. Now in question, many times it can be given to you only in the terms of speed and the time. Okay, means distance will not be given to you. So let's suppose you are given S1 speed that you have covered with for T1 duration, and S2 speed when you are covering for the T2 time. Okay, so in that case you will not worry, you will just put the value of D1 in terms of S1 and T1. So you know the S1, that is speed, is equal to distance upon time. So what you will put here, from here, that D1 is equal to S1 T1. So just put this value in this form and let's see what is coming. So our average speed now will be written as at position of D1 we will write S1 T1 plus, that is S2 T2. Okay, so and dividing with the time we get the complete value of our average speed. So similarly, if you are given with only let's suppose speed and a distance, then again you will calculate the T as you can call it D upon S. So again you will put instead of T as D by S ratio, and you can easily calculate the all the respective values. Now next thing, next topic comes, that is the your instantaneous speed. So what is instantaneous speed? It is also the ratio of distance upon time, but it is defined for very very short duration. For example, if we ask about here that what is the duration then it is the 1 second. Okay, it is the 1 second duration of time. So that is your speed. If you want to calculate, you will take the difference of the distance upon time taken. Okay, or what is the time or what is the duration taken upon time. But if I ask you that you have to calculate the speed of the body for a very short duration, let's suppose that is a very very short duration, very less than the 1 second, then this at this position whatever you will get the speed. Okay, so that is known as your instant speed or instantaneous speed. And the best example is the speedometer of your bike or a scooty that showed you the instantaneous speed. So there is a very important conclusion again, that if your body is moving with uniform speed, okay, so in that case your instantaneous speed is equal to the uniform speed. Okay, in that case it will be same as the uniform speed. So now let's talk about the velocity. Just that is the contemporary of the speed. So what is the velocity? So it is the distance covered, that is the displacement covered by the body. Displacement upon time is called as the velocity, or you can also call that the rate of change of displacement of the body is known as the velocity. So we can again write it as delta x upon delta t, that is the change in the displacement and the time of the body. And in terms of differentiation we can write, so if our time duration is very very less, so we can write it in the form of dx by dt, that is rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So again, velocity depending on the displacement, thus it is a vector quantity. Okay, that is a vector quantity, that means it will also depend on the direction. Now the second thing, that it depends on the displacement, so we can say that it can also have a value that is zero, either positive or a negative value. So that is important about the velocity if we compare it with the speed. Okay, so that is about the velocity. Now let's see the other types of velocities also, that is the classification. So again, we have also a uniform velocity. So what is the uniform velocity? If the body is covering equal displacements, in equal interval of time, and also in same direction. Okay, that means direction should also not same. Even if the displacement is same, your direction should also be same, in same direction, then such condition is known as the uniform velocity. Okay, so that is a big difference in the speed, uniform speed and the uniform velocity. Okay, that means equal displacement in equal interval of time and should also have a same direction, then it is known as uniform velocity. So that is the important thing. Now this term is also known as the uniform motion. Okay, so in uniform motion there is not mentioned any speed or velocity, so you can confuse here. But let me tell you that whenever it is written uniform motion, then you have to consider it as a uniform velocity, that we are talking about a constant velocity. Okay, so I hope this is clear. Now let's talk about a variable velocity. So what is a variable velocity? That it is again can be explained by three reasons. So let's see it. So it can have the first condition, that is equal displacement, in unequal time interval, okay, so that is the first case, equal displacement but unequal time duration. Now second is unequal displacement, in equal interval of time. So that is also comes under the variable velocity. Okay, and the third condition that is very important, that is equal, the body is covering equal distance in equal interval of time, but what happened here, the direction, yeah, that is the direction is changed, that is no same direction, then also our velocity will be considered as the variable velocity. Okay, so that is are the three factors important for us. Now let's talk about the that is the average velocity. So in average velocity, again we have a same thing, that is what we will take. We will take the total displacement in place of total distance, we will replace it with total displacement upon total time taken. Okay, so that total do not means that you will add every displacement. The total displacement means the actual displacement, the actual shortest distance between different location. So you just take the shortest distance between the initial and the final, and you will put here as a total displacement.